سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وأهله وصحبه وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. صدق الله مولانا الذي وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين. قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: ذكر الأنبياء من العبادة وذكر الصالحين كفارة. أو كما قال الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. حمد و ثنا کے بعد میرے واجب احترام بزرگ اور دوستو السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. اللہ تبارک و تعالی جل جلالہ و امن والہ کا لا تعداد ان گن بے شمار شکر ہے کہ ہمیں اشرف المخلوقات میں سے انسان پیدا فرمایا، اور صرف نہیں بلکہ ہمیں آقا انعامدار تاجدار مدینہ فخر موجودات احمد مصطفیٰ محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وسلم کے امتی بنائے. ایک شاعر نے کیا خوب فرمایا، وہی بات کو دہرا رہا ہوں انشاءاللہ. نگاہ ولی میں وہ تاثیر دیکھی، نگاہ ولی میں وہ تاثیر دیکھی، بدلتی ہزاروں کی تقدیریں دیکھی. Now the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He spoke to us in the form of the Quran through the beloved Habib Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just a continuation of yesterday, the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you ask, you are asking for hidayah, that Allah must show you that road of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rewarded, not of those that Allah has, they have gained Allah's rid, Allah's unhappiness. So it is stated, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, minan nabiyyin. Nabi ke baad kal bhi hoye. We can start from now till the day of Qiyamah, wallah, we will not finish about the greatness of my Nabi Muhammad. Ek hadith sharif bayan karunga inshallah, so that the hadith can be pura inshallah. We're sitting here, Allah will accept it as our ibad. Because Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, zikr al-anbiya'i min al-ibadah. When you make zikr of a Nabi, it is actually making ibadah of Allah. And then the ayat of the Quran, inshallah, will go on to the waliya kamileen. I'll give you a proof, inshallah, from the Quran, from the hadith, that our belief, wallah, is like the sahaba ikram. And anyone's belief that is not according to the sahaba ikram, wallah, they are gharak. For them is only that place which is lower than that place of a kafir. So it is stated that my beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when it was his time to come into this dunya, my beloved Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave every Nabi, every Rasul, a certain type of mu'jiza, a certain type of miracle. And they came down to this dunya. But when it came the time of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, wallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam any mu'jiza, any miracle. Every Nabi came down to the earth, and the people said, if you are a Nabi of Allah, give us proof. Give us proof that for sure, show us something that people can't see, can't understand. Mu'jiza, miracle is that which your mind cannot understand. So it is stated that when Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went for Miraj, The Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, ki ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, you are talking about a mu'jiza, a miracle. I have made you a miracle from your head to your toe and sent you down to this earth. Every single atom in your body, wallah, is actually, every single atom, wallah, in your body is a miracle from Allah. You yourself is a miracle. So, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how, where, what? You know, it was said in Arabia, when the people, when the children used to get married, especially the woman child, girl child. Now the person has to present attar, which is expensive. And if you bring the cheap attar and come, you say, kya fayda? So this gharib man, they knew, wallah, if they got cut in their finger, if they got hurt in their head, no matter what happened to them, whatever they wanted, wallah, they would have got in the barakah of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So it is stated that this gharib man, he goes to the barakah of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my daughter is getting married and I do not have any attar, any perfume to give. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do I do? What can I do? And it is stated that my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, go and bring a small bottle. Shisha lakya. When the bottle was brought forward to my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was stated that my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he filled a bottle with his perspiration and he gave it to this man. And he said to him, there, take this bottle of attar, take this bottle of my perspiration and give it to your daughter. And give it to your daughter and let her use it. It was stated the greatness of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so much that it is stated that that lady that put that attar one drop in her body, only one drop, it is said, wallah, 7 generations after that, the children that came out, wallah, they still had the same smell that was coming out from our body so many years, so many thousand years ago. Yani my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even his perspiration, wallah, ours would smell. But my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that kind of perfume which you and I cannot imagine. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam, we spoke about the wuzu. When he used to make wuzu, what happened when he used to make wuzu? Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam used to make wuzu, the sahaba ikram used to stand around him. They said, wait for the wuzu water to fall. You must have heard of that sahabi, Khalid bin Walid, radiallahu ta'ala, who is a general in the army. Wallah, he says that after I became Muslim, the time of Hajjatul Wida, when the sahaba ikram was standing around when Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam was cutting his hair, each and every one of them were taking a strand of hair to tabarruk and keeping with him. They were saying, he said that every single war he went to, if he did not have the Baal Mubarak of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his head, in the middle of that battle, he'll leave the battle and go home. And his aqidah and his tawakkal was as such that even that Baal Mubarak has so much of barakat because it was touched to the body of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that every war he fought with that Baal Mubarak, he won that war. This is the karam of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from his family, you look here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, minan nabiyyin. Nabi ka samajh aagaya. Zikrul anbiya'i min al ibadah. May Allah accept our first part of it with our baby making noise here. As ibadah, inshallah. And the second part where Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks about is after Nabi, there is no Nabi to come. La Nabi ibadah. But there will be awliya Allah, those that are friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you can only become a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you love Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is stated, in the time of Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam, there was a man, every day he used to wake up in the morning, he look at his neighbor, he swear his neighbor. Koi achha harkat kiya hi nahi usne. Now the people of the town thought, this man, he doesn't do anything good in his life. Wo mar gaya, he died. So they took his body and they threw it in the ground. Threw it in the street. You poor aadmi, every time you look at him, you're swearing. Who's going to go pick his body up? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, ya Musa. Who's going to pick that body up? Allah ne nabi ko bheja. Ya Musa. go to certain town, you will find a body on the ground. Ya Musa, go and give it ghusl, kafan, and bury it the proper way, wallah. Now Musa alayhi salam, Yara is going so, after so long he traveled, he comes to that place where he sees the body in the ground. Wallah, now he's thinking to himself now, Ya Allah, why do people throw his body in the ground? What reason? When he asks the people, they say, people, pura, very bad. Jo dil ke halat hai na, wo sirf Allah aur uske Rasool janta hai. You cannot judge anyone. Never ever judge anyone. You might be 10 times worse than that. Huzoor ke darbar mein jitna jhukenge, utna Allah ko uthayenge. So it is stated that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, in his bargah, there was this man in the time of Musa alayhi salam, whose body was thrown on the ground because he was a bad man. But Allah called him, Nabi, he said, Ya Musa, you go. Leave the people. What I know, you do not know. Jo main janta hu, tum bhi nahi janta. Say, Ya Musa, go give him kafan and dafan. Musa went, he did kafan, he went dafan, everything, proper. Now he turned to Allah. Say, Ya Allah, but if the man was bad in his life, any hukukul ibad, he couldn't fulfill the actions of his hukuk with the people that are around him. Ya Allah, why you sent a Nabi to do a kafan and dafan? Say, Ya Musa, La ilma lana illa ma allamtana innaka antal alimul hakim. The farishtas said the same thing. Ya Allah, we don't know anything. We only know what you taught us. They say, Ya Musa, you don't know. He was a bad man, yes. But every morning he used to open the Torah. And wherever he used to see Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Ya Allah, all those that you love, I love, Ya Allah. But I am a bad man. So sadaqah and wasila of that dua and that respect he had for the Ahlul Bayt and the family of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave that maqam where he sent a Nabi to give him kafan and dafan. Kaisa maqam. Allah hum sabko Nabi ki izzat karne ki tawfiq ata farmaye. Some people today they're saying, if you think of a donkey in your namaz is accepted. But if you think of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in your namaz is not accepted. Allah hum sabko hidayat naseeb farmaye. Jo bina iske Nabi se padhte hain Bukhari, bukhar aate hain unko, nahi aate Bukhari. So it is stated that we come now to the last night, alhamdulillah. Last night, I'm saying alhamdulillah, but it is a sad night. Because every night we used to come together and make ibadat of Allah. And tonight is the last night of that. But what happens to a person when he works hard the whole month? Come end of the month, what happens? He's ready for his pay. Eh? They're standing. They call this night Laylatul Jaza. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is distributing that sawab and that reward to each and every one of us. And it is stated, wallah, if a person standing in ibadat in this night also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also give him sawab and forgive him for all his guna. Allah's karam, beniyas. I said to you the other day, Laylatul Qadr, no matter what guna you make in your life, no matter how big that guna is, no matter how great that guna is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ma gharraka bi rabbika al-kareem. Where are you running away from Allah? Tujhe mere paas yana hoga. Go where you want to go. At the end, where are you going to go? You're going to come to me. And whose mercy is more? Mine or your guna? Like how that one boy of Musa alayhi salam time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Musa, go and tell that boy is over 30 years old, every single day he made guna. I'm very cross with you. When Musa alayhi salam jaake ka, Allah is very cross with you. Because every day you made guna, not one day you did good. What he did? He ran in the field. He opened his hand, he said, Ya Allah! From two things, tell me one thing. Is my guna more than your karam? Your rahmat? Or your rahmat is more than my guna? That's all, my brother. And for sure, Allah's rahmat and his karam is more than that. How do we learn to go to the mazarat of the awliya Allah? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is sitting in Madinatul Munawwara. He said, come and tell you about a man who killed 99 men. Hadith, authentic hadith. 99 men, cold blooded. Why? I just felt like killing. Marty. So he goes on a search to look for someone that can show him how to make Tawbah from Allah. He only had that intention in his mind. And he started walking. He comes across a rahib. Rahib is a priest. So he asks the rahib, you know, I killed 99 men cold-blooded. There is any way Allah will forgive? 99 men. They're too cold-blooded. Allahu Akbar. Hey, wait, God will never forgive you. You'll burn in hell. He said, if I'm going to burn in hell, I'd rather make 99 more. 100. Hey, pura number banana. And what did he say? He killed him too. And he still walked. After killing him, made 100. Now he walks for some time. He comes to a man. He asks him, you know what? I killed 100 men. Is there any way Allah will forgive me? He said, Allah to bani yaze. Tawakkaltu ala Allah. La taknatu min rahmatillah. Do not put your own limits in the rahmat of Allah. Allah's rahmat is so much for Allah which you and I cannot imagine. You know, Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ek baat mein sunata hun. They say that Hazrat Sayyid Ahmad Rifai silsila. One day he says, it was stated that his ruh was flying in the air. You know, the walis of Allah, they can be sitting in one place, but the ruh can travel. They say now, that ruh is traveling in the sky. So kisi ne usse pucha, hey, what are you doing here? He said, no, I want to see where the last point when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam put his foot when he went for Miraj. Sayyid Ahmad Rifai. He said, hey, Sayyid Ahmad Rifai, go back. Because 70,000 times more than where you think his leg went, he went more further than that. To kabhi us jagah tak pahunch nahi sakta. This is a karam of Allah. Allah's Nabi. So Allah's Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this man now, he said, 100 men. 100 men, cold-blooded. No problem. See, not far from here, there is a place where there are some people that are making the ibadat of Allah. Go and sit with them. Maybe Allah, through their sadaqah, Allah will also forgive you. Like a man came to steal shoes from the masjid. Ye koi galat kaam karne ke liye aaya. What Allah said to the angel? Forgive everybody. He said, Ya Allah, that man came there, Ya Allah, he wasn't supposed to be there. But he was sitting there. He said, jo mere bando ke saath baithe hai, usko bhi bakhsh do. So this man now, he hears this now. The basti is there far. He take one step like this. Malak al-Maut come and take his soul. Now, when Malak al-Maut take his soul out, the farishtas from Jannat and the farishtas from Jahannam came. Dono aage. Farishtas from Jahannam, why you came? Ya Allah, we came because this man killed 100 men, cold-blooded. Hey, farishtas from Jannat. Why you came? See, Ya Allah, ye to nikla hai tere bargah ki tarah. Nikla hai tere awliya ki tarah. That's why we came. Now the fight was on. Hadith says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them to his court. Come here. Why are you fighting? See, Ya Allah, you killed 100 men. Let's go to Jahannam. Okay, come. Let's do it like this. Go back down. Go and measure the earth. Where that man told him that there is the basti of that awliya Allah. If this man is more closer to the town of the awliya, take him and go to Jannat. But if he is very far away from the town of the awliya, if you only took one step, let's go to Jahannam. That's what told me. Now the angels are coming down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O earth, pull yourself together. Don't you know where he was going? Wallah, the earth pulled itself together. And when they went to measure, they saw that this man was closer to the basti of the awliya. And to the sadaqah and wasila of the awliya Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave that man. For 100 men that he killed cold-blooded. What worse can a person do in this life? What worse can he do? But still Allah forgave him. Who are you? Who am I? We are nothing. Our gunas are nothing compared to many other people that make guna. Allah shukr. We're not so bad. Allah will forgive that man. He can't forgive us. Ask for forgiveness, my brothers in Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us on the straight path of Allah. These are lessons we learn from the awliya Allah. We learn from the hadith of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اولیاء کے مزارات پہ جانا یہ بھی سنت. حضور صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم خود فرما رہے ہیں یہ کس کا سنت. People came before us. ہم تو پیدا ہی نہیں ہوئے. We weren't even born that time. We are bidatis. Where those people came before, they were going to the mazara. They were going to the awliya Allah. And through a sadaqah of the awliya Allah, they got forgiven. So my brothers in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of that. The awliya Allah are those people that are close to Allah. Allah, so close that it is stated that Allah ke bande jo hai, aise bhi hote hai. Dua karna dur ki baat hai. Zin mein baat aaj hai, khuda unko nawaz de. You know what that means? He said, Allah's walis are as such that they reach a maqam that is so high. We keep on saying, Hazrat, dua karo, dua karo, dua karo. It is stated that these people, the awliyas of Allah, they only have to think about it for hujjat. They think of something, it happens. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding to understand that we have seen with our eyes, wallah, the awliya Allah, that living waliya kamil, our ustad, naib ghawsi azam, Sayyid Haseenuddin Shah Sahab, damu barakatuhu al-aliyah. دعا کرنا تو دور کی بات ہے یار, صرف ان کو بتا دینا, ان کی زبان سے ایک لفظ نکلنا, اتنی بات ہے اور اللہ اس کو قبول فرما لے. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of that and make us follow his نقش قدم انشاءاللہ. اللہ کہے جانے سے اللہ کو نہ ملے, اللہ والے ہیں وہ جو اللہ سے ملا دیتے ہیں. May Allah give us all hidayah to follow that straight path انشاءاللہ. من النبیین والصدقین والشہداء والصالحین وما علينا الى البلاد المبين. جزاكم الله خير. امين. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبه للمتقين والصلاه والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى اله واصحابه اجمعين. يا رسول الله انظر حالنا, يا حبيب الله اسمع قولنا, اننا في بحر غم مغرق خذ يدي سهل لنا اشغالنا. یا الہی رحم فرما مصطفیٰ کے واسطے, یا رسول اللہ کرم کیجئے خدا کے واسطے, مشکلیں حل کر شہ مشکل کشا کے واسطے, کربلا ہے رج شہید کربلا کے واسطے. یا الہی جو کچھ ہم نے جو درس حدیث درس قرآن ہم نے کی ہے, یا الہی اس کو آپ کے دربار میں قبول اور مقبول فرما. نائب غوث اعظم سید حسین الدین شاہ صاحب کے صدقے طفیل, یا الہی کہ ہمارے اوپر رحم اور کرم فرما, تمام مشکلات کو دور فرما. یا الہی ہمیں عزت فرما, حفاظت فرما. اللہم تقبل هذه درس قرآن درس حدیث مع جماعت المسلمین فی غلستان محیدین ببرکت ان اللہ ملائکتہ یسلمون علی النبی یا ایوہ الذین آمنوا صلوا علیہ وسلموا تسلیما. اللہم صلی علی سیدنا مولانا محمد وعلی آل سیدنا مولانا وبارک وسلم وسلم علیہ بفضل سبحان ربک رب العزت عما یصفون وسلام علی المرسلین والحمد للہ رب العالمین بحق لا الہ الا اللہ محمد رسول اللہ صلی اللہ تعالی علیہ وآلہ وسلم بارک وسلم.
This is who, Ali? No?
Sophie.
This is Sophie, though.
That's how you put it back.